Problema ng ekonomiya natin, ang problema ng ating ng mga Pilipino ay trabaho. And the only way to create jobs is to increase economic activity. And one of the best ways to increase economic activity, it's not the only way, but one of the best ways to increase economic activity is public investment. Wala tayong nakikita masyadong public investment. But not in infrastructure, not in food supply, not in tourism, which is a nice, good cash-generating activity, economic activity. All of these things. It just makes us, now we have started to see the effects. If you have noticed, all commodity prices are slowly going up, or not so slowly going up. And the reason that the commodity prices have slowly gone up, because we have not invested in production, we have not invested in all of the things, so that the supply, it's a supply and demand problem, so that the supply is sufficient, then we can control or at least influence the prices. Secondly, minalas din sila dahil nagkaroon ng gulo sa Middle East, ang daming umuwi na trabahador, ngayon nandito sila, wala silang trabaho. In fact, many of our workers na nung sinabi na pwede na silang umuwi, sabi nila hindi na lang. Kahit pinaparin sila doon, okay na lang, they'll take the risk dahil pag uwi nila wala silang trabaho. So this is we have to recognize that the main problem that we have to face is the lack of jobs, the unemployment levels here in this country. The country we've always been traditionally underemployed. The problem has traditionally been underemployment. It is now no longer underemployment. It is really truly unemployment. And if anything, I think that we have lost direction. We question whether or not, there's no debate that there are poor people in the country who need any assistance that they can get. But we must prioritize the spending of government. If we spend more on public investment, on infrastructure, on all the basics of the economy, then there is a return to that. Ang social programs na binang, like the CCT, like all of these social assistance, you know, the CCT is $25 billion, that's $600 million, that's real money. And ang nagiging problema dyan is that we have not conducted it. Lagi nila sinasabi na it was successful in Brazil, it was successful in San. Hindi, the way we have done it is different. So, walang magiging return doon, walang social effect. Kung hindi, para tumulong lang sa mga mahihirap na nangangailangan ng pera, nangangailangan ng tulong. But wala na, hanggang doon na lang yun. And then, kung itutuloy natin yun, wala tayong gagawin, kundi taon-taon, buwan-buwan ang babayad. Whereas kung mag-invest ka sa infrastructure, mag-invest ka, tulungan mo yung mga negosyante, ayusin ninyo yung financial system, we work more on for foreign direct investment. All of these things, even trabahuhin natin yan, may return yan. May kikita yung mga negosyante, magkakaroon ng trabaho, may return yan. Hindi yung basta bigay lang ng bigay ng pera. That's always been the problem with dole-outs. So, that is, if you ask me for an assessment, I think we have to reassess the direction that was initially taken by this administration to focus on social assistance rather than public investment in the economy. I believe, kasi kung titignan natin ang example ng so-called tiger economies of Asia, they all went for public investment in the economy. They tried their best to have some effect on a social level na tumutulong sa mga, like in terms of education, healthcare, all of those things. But essentially, the thrust was to help business to grow the economy. And that's what we have taken a different direction. I would just think that considering that the success that the other countries in Southeast Asia have enjoyed under that policy of investing in the economy, then maybe that is an example that we should hew closer to. Kailangan ba siguro mas doon tayo nag-iisip. The other problem is because the social programs, well-intentioned as they may be, have not been implemented as well as we could have hoped. Again, I don't mean to be saying I told you so, but this is what we were fearing since the budget hearings.
Sir, another question. Sir, what's your position on charter change?
My position on charter change has long been, I've said it a long, long time. We have, there are changes that are needed to the to our constitution for the simple reason that things have changed and there are things that are in fact, even Father Bernas has always said, even when it was first, the 87 Constitution was finally approved, even the framers of the Constitution all said that this is a work in progress. Na kailangan balikan, that there are things that need to be done. For one reason or another, hindi na nabalikan, but I think it's time that we need to go back and study it properly. Because there really are many, many things that... But you know, you have to consider that the government in 1986, then the constitution of 1987, were pretty much a blank sheet of paper. So they were written on a blank sheet of paper. So you must see at least parts of it as experiments. And so we have to see if these experiments have succeeded or have failed. If they've succeeded, let's continue to do that. If they have not succeeded, then we better come up with a better solution.